Hello and welcome to Banker Binary's Ahead of the Week report for February 17th to 21st. I'm Sarah Fenwick, bringing you all the important trading and market events for the next 5 days. Remember that all time stated are GMT. The Eurogroup meets on Monday the 17th and is expected to discuss the latest developments in the fragile economic recovery and ongoing bailout programs in Cyprus, Portugal and Greece. Cyprus just got a pass mark from the latest Troika review, paving the way for a further 235 million euros in loans from the EU and IMF. Meanwhile, in France, the latest GDP figures showed a slight rise to 0.3%, bringing the EU's second largest economy out of recession. Overall, the Eurozone managed to stay out of recession for the last three quarters of 2013. On Tuesday the 18th, Bank of Japan releases its interest rate decision and monetary policy statement at 0300. During its last meeting, BOJ kept its interest rate unchanged at a record low of 0.1%. The BOJ is sticking to its plan to expand Japan's monetary base to 70 trillion yen, but look out for anything unexpected that could trigger a price change in the USD/JPY. At 9:30 on Tuesday morning, the UK releases its annual consumer price index for January 2014, expected to stay unchanged at 2%. Last week, Bank of England Governor Mark Carney said the inflation environment was more benign than expected. But keep a wary eye out for anything that could pollute this environment during the inflation update. A sharp drop or rise in CPI could move the GBP/USD very suddenly. At 10 a.m., Germany's ZEW economic sentiment survey results for February are due to be announced. This important indicator is expected to stay at the level of 61.7. And although Germany's economy has remained relatively robust, the markets are still extremely sensitive to the survey's results, which have the power to move the Euro/USD. Wednesday the 19th is another big day for market events, particularly around the GBP/USD. Bank of England releases its minutes and interest rate vote at 9:30 a.m. At the same time, the UK's claimant count change and ILO unemployment rate for December are due to be announced. The ILO rate is expected to remain unchanged at 7.1%. This headline figure may not be as critical to the Bank of England's monetary policy as it used to be after BOE Governor Carney said that interest rates would not be raised even after unemployment reached a targeted 7% threshold because the BOE would not take risks with the recovery. At 7 p.m. on Wednesday, the FOMC releases its minutes with new chairwoman Janet Yellen at the head of the most powerful monetary policy organization in the world. Tapering is the key word here as investors watch out for further signals that the Federal Reserve will cut back its asset purchase program further. On Thursday the 20th, the highlight of the day is the annual US Consumer Price Index for January, which is expected to remain unchanged at 1.5%. That's out at 13:30. Finally, for Thursday, Bank of Japan releases its monetary policy meeting minutes at 23:50. Friday the 21st brings CAD traders a potential opportunity for price changes during the release of Canada's annual consumer price index for January. Look out for that at 13:30. It's expected to have risen to 1.3% from 1.2% previously. Remember to contact your account manager to ask about the main market events and trading opportunities for the week of the 17th to 21st of February and learn more about trading binary options by visiting Bank Debinary's free new education centre at bankdebinary.net. Thanks for watching Ahead of the Week with me, Sarah Fenwick. Until next week, goodbye.